though. Absolutely. Yes. Thanks very much.
She's very pleased. Out there for 3 hours. Where's the adder? We have a burst of sunshine on our show for this morning.
Da-da.
Helen Mirren. Good morning, Helen.
Good morning.
Lovely to see you. And you look so gorgeously spring-like.
Well, it is spring out there. It's so beautiful driving in today. You know, the sun on Hyde Park and everyone out on their bicycles and running. The flags down the mall for the wedding. It's just lovely to be here.
We're still stuck in February.
It's like being in that C.S. Lewis story. It's always, not winter, but always nighttime in the studio.
Yes,
there's no window.
Right.
So thanks very much for telling us what it's like in
the rain is glorious out there. Yeah.
We'll talk to you more in a moment about your new film, Arthur, in which you star with Russell Brand. Mm-hmm. And it's a remake of a big film with Dudley Moore.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll compare the two in a moment. First, let's get a last quick look at what's happening where you are.
Very good morning. I'm Asad Ahmed. The BBC understands that the organisers of London 2012 are to get their way in a row over money with the British Olympic Association. The BOA, which is entitled to 20% of any profit from the Games, had argued that only the Olympics should be taken into account. But London 2012 insisted that the Paralympics should also be considered in the payout. Look at the travel situation now, and after last Friday's fire, the M1 has now reopened two lanes in both directions, which has eased traffic problems in the area, as you can see. Now in South London, the Rotherhithe Tunnel is closed because of a fire there, leaving delays for the A13 through Limehouse and also along Jamaica Road through Bermondsey. Finally, on the trains, buses are replacing southeastern services between Ashford International and Maidstone East. Now, the UK Border Agency has been criticised for holding immigrant children overnight in what are described as degrading conditions at Heathrow Airport. The airport's independent monitoring board says that over 15,000 people were detained in holding rooms last year with poor ventilation and no adequate washing facilities. Motorcyclists fighting Westminster's £1-a-day parking charge should learn the outcome of the latest round of their legal battle today. The Nota Bike Parking Tax campaign is against the charge, but Westminster Council say they have thousands of free spaces for bikes in their car parks. Today's weather, dry, sunny and feeling warm. Simple as that. High of 25 Celsius. That's it. I'll be back at 1:30 on BBC One.
Welcome back. Dame Helen Mirren is known for taking on very weighty roles. She's won an Oscar, of course, for her portrayal of Queen Elizabeth II in Stephen Frears' film The Queen. She's won Emmys for her performance as Detective Jane Tennyson in the television series Prime Suspect.
So it might have been a bit of a surprise to see that her latest role is a comedy opposite the irrepressible Russell Brand. She plays Nanny Hobson in Arthur. It's a remake of the 1981 classic about the billionaire playboy made to choose between money and love. What a choice. What a choice.
Before we speak to Helen, we're going to have a look at the film. Here it is.
When I was little, you used to say, Arthur, you can do anything under the sun.
I never spoke like that.
It was a bit like that.
That was before you paid Elton John $2 million to sing over the PA in a grocery store.
Yeah, well, it was Easter. I think I could live without the money.
Oh, yes? How?
I'd get a job.
What? Fine. Fine, go ahead. Get a job.
I am a grown man and I shall join the mature world of gainful employment to prove it. Don't let that undermine what I just said.
Morning, Helen. Lovely to have you with us again. Big difference. You're not a man.
I'm not a man and I'm not a queen.
Because in the original it was John Gielgud.
It was indeed John Gielgud. And it's funny because somehow my career hasn't exactly paralleled John Gielgud's, but he was always my inspiration because of the choices he made. You know, he was this great knight of the British theatre, but he would choose to do things like work with Peter Greenaway or do Arthur, you know, which most of those kind of knights of the theatre would never have dreamt of doing something like that. So that always inspired me. He always took kind of edgy choices.
Yes, and he swore a lot, as I remember. And
that, there was well, in that sort of wonderful voice he had.
Exactly. No, that was
you
the
little.
Oh, no, we can't say that.
I'm so sorry.
Take that back. That never happened.
No, well, it was in the original film.
If you heard that, we're very sorry. Otherwise, we get fired.
I'm so sorry.
Okay.
Don't worry. I do apologise.
This is why we pre-recorded you last time.
Absolutely.
Helen Marriage got foul mouth, Helen. When you received the script then, What were your initial thoughts? Had you seen the original Arthur?
I had seen the original Arthur. Actually, quite honestly, I didn't much like the original Arthur. Mm. I thought Dudley Moore was brilliant, of course, and all the cast were great, but I didn't like the idea of the enabling of an alcoholic in that way, the way he tottered off into the at the end of the film just as drunk as he was at the beginning. Mm-hmm. Actually, it was really meeting with Russell that made me want to do this movie. Mm. I met with him, I spent a couple of hours chatting and mostly laughing, as you can imagine, and being charmed, because he's very charming. And at the end of that meeting, I just said, yeah, I'll do it, yeah, fine, because I just wanted to work with him, really.
So, do you become big buddies on set?
Yes, certainly on the set. You know, he's fantastic to work with. He's just amazing work ethic. He's all the time funny, just makes everybody laugh all the time. Very brilliant, very quick-witted. And so, you know, the work process was absolutely great. You know, we didn't really hang off the set. We didn't, like, go out to dinner or anything. Yeah. But we were working so hard, we never went out to dinner anyway.
There seemed to be a lot of ad-libbing. That's how it seemed on just there watching
was,
the film.
Yes, there was
he
quite
was doing
a
lot of off-the-cuff.
Absolutely. I mean, obviously, Russell, with his improvisational background, and that's kind of what he does, you know, he can't stop himself. Yes, there was a lot of improvising. Mm. Yes, absolutely.
So, in the original, Dudley Moore does drink a lot.
Yes, indeed he does.
Is seen to be consorting with ladies of the night. Whereas in the new version, Russell Brand does drink a lot and is heard to be consorting with ladies of the night because you refer to it as your character. But, so what is the difference then? What is more redemptive about him as opposed to the other one, without giving too much away, I suppose?
Well, I think he comes to realise the error of his ways or of his lifestyle in our movie. I think it's more of a re-envisioning of the original film than an actual sort of remake. I think also, obviously, casting me as a nanny as opposed to a man as a butler really kind of shifts the whole feeling of the film. I think it's got more heart for my money. Mm-hmm. I think our film has got more heart, more kind of romance in it.
Yes, and yours is quite a nice warm character, although you seem quite austere. You do.
Well, I think just being a woman, somehow that shifts it, you know. Mm-hmm. I found the same thing playing Prospero in The Tempest, that just being a woman, just although you don't have to kind of act warm or anything, just being a woman just shifts the impetus of
and
it.
And Russell Brand, of course, was as well, wasn't he?
Both looking very charming there, aren't we?
Did you meet him much?
No, we didn't. No, because we were in different parts
exactly,
of the film.
Yeah.
We sort of waved at each other across the set, and he did give me his underpants at the end of the film.
Oh, charming!
Have
which
you still
was
them?
Very, very kind of him.
And you still
I do
wanted
have
to work
them.
With him.
No, I asked for them. I have to
did
say.
You really?
Yes, I was like some sort of pathetic little groupie. You know, the awful, really.
Is it something you've done with other people? Do you collect?
No,
them?
I'm making a collection
don't
now.
Helen down there again.
Any, if you have any going spare, you gratefully.
If only
I. Charmed to. I'm. I am not.
If only I'd known. Helen. Think quick.
Yes.
What struck me about, I don't want to call him Hudson.
Is he Hobson?
Hobson.
Blushing now.
Yes,
yeah.
I know. Should I give them to her later or not?
Let me guess what they are. I know they're Bobheads.
Stop it. Hobson.
All our guests on the sofa, I would have thought you'd have been the least amount of trouble, Helen. Thank you.
Somebody who once played royalty. Hobson at times reminded me of Jane Tennyson because she's very.
Yes, it's true. It's that sort of. And that's why I really didn't want to wear black. You know, navy blue suits or anything like that. I did not want to look like a policewoman, and I didn't want to sort of the vibe to be a sort of guard or a policewoman kind of thing. That's why I'm in pink and stuff like that. But yes, I guess it does have a little bit of that sort of, you know, strict, straightforward, you know, describe it how it is kind of a person. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
yeah, mm-hmm. Absolutely.
You mentioned playing the Queen a little earlier. Would you mind if we just indulged ourselves and had a little
look to do it.
From the film? Here's
Here
a clip.
Go.
Oh, from the of the
now
film.
There is
yeah,
anyone who knows the British people more than I do, Mr. Blair, nor who has greater faith in their wisdom and judgment. And it is my belief that they will any moment reject this mood, which is being stirred up by the press, in favour of a period of restrained grief and sober private mourning. That's the way we do things in this country, quietly, with dignity. It's what the rest of the world has always admired us for.
If that's your decision, then, of course, the government will support it. Let's keep in touch.
Yes, let's.
It was a big film, that, wasn't it? It really was a big film. When
it
you
was
made
a wonderful
it,
film,
well, you,
yes.
you must have been aware. I mean, I know you've had talk about it an awful lot. You must have been aware that it was, well, if not thin ice, then sort of.
Yes, of course. You know. Oh my goodness me! Absolutely, I was terrified going into that film. And I knew I'd have to be. It wasn't really the doing of it. It was what I might have to deal with after having done it. The eggshells I knew I'd have to walk on every time I made any kind of a public appearance talking about it. I knew I'd have to be incredibly careful, and I was. And then, of course, you know, and then it got nominated for various things, so then I got more and more exposed and more terrified of saying or doing the wrong thing. But it was a great honour to have done it. It was a great experience for me in many, many ways. And I have to say right now, you know, coming up to the royal wedding.
Yes. You'll be watching closely?
Yes, of course I will. I want to know what she's wearing, don't
That's
you?
The thing.
I mean, absolutely.
Even if you have not a lot of interest in the wedding itself,
no,
everybody wants to know what.
But I'm really hoping it'll be beautiful weather. And if it is, you know, it'll be a great celebratory sort of wonderful day. And I'm really looking forward to it.
Where are you going to be
it.
Watching it?
Actually, I won't be here, unfortunately. So I'll be watching it on television. The great thing is, wherever I am in the world,
you'll see it.
It'll be on TV.
Yeah,
so.
It's lovely
Helen,
to have you
thanks
back.
Very much.
Thank you very
Thank
much
you.
For joining
Thanks
us.
For having
Thank
me.
Thank you.
And Arthur is released in cinemas this